A very good morning, dear students. Welcome back to your social studies class. And today we will start a new chapter from history, chapter 2, the early societies. Chapter 2, the early societies. Then you know the first man, they appeared on the earth the thousands of years ago, and the early man was an ape-like creature called the hominid. They are like a monkeys, and according to the anthropologists, they are saying that the human beings, they are appeared on the earth in African continent. First they appeared in the African continent, then later the passage of time they spread all over the world. And the early men, they were the food gatherer. They were taking the food, or they are from the wild fruits and the roots and the small insects and the worms, that are the food they were eating, the early men. And he lived in a cave. Where they were living, they are living in the caves. There is no the houses, which houses it, now it is having the same houses, it was not there in the earlier time. And they were living in the caves, and gradually man began to stand erect, and he also developed the flexible fingers and opposable thumb. And with the passage of time, his hands developed to pick up and throw the things. And the passage of times, what they were doing, it is picking up the things, and they were started to throw the things. And slowly he learned to adapt himself to his surroundings, and he was adapting himself in his surrounding where he is living there only. And he learned to make tools. After that, what happened? He was learning to make the tools. What are the things it is available? The stones and all. With the stones and all, he was started to make the tools. Before, only he were collecting the food from the wild fruits and all. They were collecting, and or they are plucking, or they are taking and eating. But now slowly, gradually, they started to make the tools. And since stone were used on the large scale, and they were using the stone in the large scale, so they started to use the stones as a tools. They were making the stone into tools. So the it is started the stone age. We can see here in this age, the early men, it is started the first, it is a stone age. The stone age, what is the stone age? The stone age started more than 1 million years ago. The stone age, it started in the 1 million years ago, and the first tool using ancestors of modern man appeared. The stone age covered the longest period of man's existence on the earth, and the stone age, it is covered the longest time the man, they were existing on the earth. And we can see the stone age, it is divided into three periods. We can see the Paleolithic age and Mesolithic age and the Neolithic age. These are the three periods you can see in the stone age. The stone age is divided into three periods. This first one, it is the Paleolithic age and the Mesolithic age and the Neolithic age. These are the three periods we can see in the stone age. And then we can see apart from the stone, man used the bone and wood and animal's horn to make the tools and the weapons. And the man, apart from the stone, they were using the wood and the bone and all this, all they were using to make the stones. And in this chapter, we will learn about the life of the people in the during the Stone Age. How the people, they were living in the Stone Age. Already I told that in Stone Age, it is divided into three periods: the Paleolithic age, or the and the Mesolithic age and the Neolithic age. And today we can see about the Paleolithic age. Here we can see the Paleo means old, Lith means stone. The Paleo means it is the old, and the Lith means stone. How? And the Paleolithic means it is the old stone age. The Paleolithic means it is the old stone age. And the old stone age, or the Paleolithic age, is also divided into three periods. You can see early Paleolithic, middle Paleolithic, and the later Paleolithic. These are the Paleolithic age. It is divided into three periods: the early, middle, and the later Paleolithic period. And we can see what are the lifestyle of the people, the Paleolithic period time, how the people or their lifestyle, how they were living in that time. First we can see the hunting and gathering. The people, they started to hunt, do the hunting. The people, they were hunting and gathering. We can see People of the Paleolithic age were wanderers and shifting from place to place in search of animal and food. And the people, they started in the Paleolithic age time, the people, they started to move from one place to other places for what? To hunting the animals and for their food. For these, their people, they started to move from one place to other places. And their way of life was hunting and gathering. We have also come across the archaeological evidences of the stone tools used by the people of this age. And in this period, the people, they were using the stone tools. They were taking the stones and they were making the tools, and they were using these tools for the hunting and all. Then later, slowly they started to live in a group. First they were hunting and gathering, and after that they living in groups. After they started to live in the groups, the Paleolithic men realized the advantages of living together. The people, they come to know that if they are living together in one groups and all, what are the advantages they can make. And it enabled them to hunt large animals and to share food, which was scarce and decayed easily. And when they started to live in the group together, they started to do the hunting. The large animals they are hunting, and they are sharing that one to among that group, the people, they were sharing and they were eating. It also provided security against the natural dangers. And this also, when they are living in the small groups and all, it is making them, it is providing to security against the natural dangers. And again, we can see there were small groups. They are making the small groups, and in the small group, the members of a group, they are cooperating with one another. What all the collections or the what all the things they are getting, they are sharing with each other. Then they are cooperating with each other in that small group. If then already we told that the people, they were living in the small groups and all. If the other from the if they are not part of their group, the people, those who are coming there, they are not collaborating with that, or the outsiders was not easily accepted in that group. They are not accepting the outside people. Only in that group, they what whom they are there, they are sharing only within themselves. There were no inequalities within the group. There in the among the group, there is no any inequality or anything, and nor were there any family ties. And the Paleolithic man's life was full of danger, and his lifespan was only 20 to 25 years. And the lifetime, the Paleolithic time, their lifetime, it is only they are having 20 to 25 years. And the next one, we can see the Paleolithic tools. We told that they are making with the stones, the tools they were making, and they were using that tools for the hunting. And we can see their tools were usually made of chipping stones, and stone tools were of two kinds, the core and the flake tools. The core tools, the two types stone tools were there, the core and the flake tools. We can see what is the core tools. The core tools were made by chipping of pieces from the chunks of rock or hand-sized pebbles. They were large heads used for the digging earth, cutting trees, sharpening wood, etc. Then the core tools they were making from the rock and all, they were shaping, or they were cutting the rocks, and they are taking these stones to make the tools. And these tools they were using for the cutting the trees and the sharpening the wood and etc. And they used stone axes as a main tool and carried it as a personal weapon. And they are using the stone axes, and they are it is the main tools for them. And we can see the some of these stone implements have been found in the Son River Valley in Pakistan and Upper Narmada and the near Chennai. These tools we can, or the stone implements we can find out from these places. And next it is a flake tools. The flake tools were made from the sharp pieces. Already we told the core tools. From when they are cutting the core tools, the sharp pieces, it will fall down from there. With the sharp tools, they were making the flake tools. And with the sharp pieces, they were making the flake tools. And these flake tools, they were using for the skinning the animals. And these are the two type of tools, or the core tools and the flake tools. And next we can see the different ways of chipping stones, how they were chipping the stones. And the Paleolithic people, they were used the direct and the indirect method for the chipping the stones. And we can see from the pebbles or the piece of bone or wood was used for the hammer to chip off the pieces from the softer pebble or the chunk of stone in the direct method. The direct method, they were using the sharp bones or the wood, they are making that, and like a hammer they were using. And the indirect method, they were keeping the tools or the long pointed piece on the bone or the wood was then placed on it like a chisel, and the hammered with another piece of a bone or wood or a stone. Then they are keeping the wood or the bone pieces inside the stone, and they were making the tools. These are the different ways how they are making the chipping stones. And next we can see the discovery of fire. They were made the stone tools, and after they started to discovery of the fire. Then already we told that there it is available the stones, more stones were there. Then how they started to discover the fire? They took the two stones and they were rubbing the stones and made the fire. We can see here the discovery of fire was probably accidental, and perhaps they rubbed a stone with another stone that protected, sprang, and ultimately lighted a fire. Then when they took the two stones and they were rubbing, it came the sparks, and it ultimately lighted the fire. So by sticking two stones together, they could start a fire whenever they wanted. So they come to know when they are starting, when they are rubbing two stones, they are getting the fire. So whenever it is needed, the fire it is needed, they started to rub the stone and get the fire. And in the course of time, they might have also discovered that fire could be used for the cooking. Then so they slowly started the fire to make the cooking, to use for the cooking and all. They now had softer and tastier meat. And before we told they were hunting the animals and all. Before the invention of fire, what they did, they were eating, or discovery of fire, they were eating the things or the animal and all the same way they are eating. But after the discovery of fire, they cooked and they were started to eat. Then after that, they understood the animals taste and all after cooking. The fire also killed the germs in a raw meat, and the fire is killing the germs from the meat and thus improving their health. Then now they started to improve their health. This also helped them scare away the animals while resting in cave. And when they are resting in the cave and all, the fire, because of fire, the animals, they won't come that side. So these are the discovery of fire. When they discovered the fire, what all the health and all, what all the things they got, the tasty food and all, then they slowly they were starting to do the many things. And from this class we have studied about the Stone Age. The Stone Age is divided into three periods: the Paleolithic Age, the Mesolithic Age, and the Neolithic Age. And you know what is the Paleolithic Age, and in this class we discuss how the people, they were living in the Paleolithic Age, and they were hunting and gathering. The people, they were doing the hunting and the gathering, and they started to live in a small groups and all. Then they started to make the, with the stones, they made the tools, and last they started the discovery of fire. So we discussed the Paleolithic people, how they lived in that time, and in the next class we will discuss about the Mesolithic Age and the Neolithic Age.